Hi, my name is Jason Kang. I'm a full-stack developer working in South Korea. When we deployed our project on cloud, we used Nginx. And if you remember, I spent a good amount of time installing it and setting it up. Nginx is a web server. When we talked about how the backend works, I told you guys how server is a computer that runs an application. That's a hardware aspect of a server. But as a software, web server controls how users access the application. In our case, the application is the HTML file we created. It holds all the information about the HTML structure and what kind of styles are applied. So web server controls how users access the application through HTTP requests. If you watch the video on DNS, you know that accessing a website means making a request to a server. And Nginx is known to handle more than 10,000 requests at once. So a lot of big companies like Google, Facebook, and LinkedIn are known to use Nginx as their web server, because they have a lot of users trying to access their services at once. Another cool aspect of Nginx is that it works as a reverse proxy server. That means it directs clients' requests to the appropriate applications. If you remember, I opened port 80 on HTTP settings on Naver Cloud platform. So if a request comes into port 80, Nginx sends the request to the block that we created. You can consider port numbers like actual ports where ships embark. Just like ships are allowed to embark at their designated ports, users can only access the server through the ports that are open. And number 80 is the default or standard port of HTTP requests. Just like a C port has a lot of ports available, a server can have open multiple ports at the same time. For example, we have our blog running on port 80. We're going to talk about this later on, but I can have project A running on port 3000 and another project B running on port 5000. And Nginx will figure out what kind of project the user is trying to access and direct the request to relevant projects or appropriate applications. There is also another popular web server called Apache. There are some arguments about which one is better, but I think it's just a personal choice to make depending on your needs. And that's it for today. And as always, if you want to learn something specific, please leave them in the comments below so I can answer your questions. Thank you and stay tuned.